Thank you. Could we all take a seat? We're going to call the meeting to order. Thank you. Could all just quiet down, please? Thank you. Thanks, everyone, for coming tonight to the annual spring meeting. Before we start tonight, I'd like to observe a moment of silence for both a Shepherd Hill student who lost his life over the weekend, as well as Officer Tarantino, who gave his life in the line of duty the other day. Thank you. If we could all rise for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Before I start the warrant, just a few housekeeping measures. If everyone could please be seated and not stand. I would appreciate that. If you're wearing a hat, I'd ask that you remove it, please, for our bylaws. If you're not a registered voter, I'd ask that you come down and sit in one of the first two rows. Again, part of what I do here tonight, besides move the meeting along, is to keep decorum. I ask that we respect each other here tonight. I ask that we wait to be recognized to speak, and that we try to keep chatter amongst each other to a minimum. Also, there'll be times when I'll call a vote. If I am confused, I probably will be doing a standing vote. We have some items tonight. If it is just a called out vote, believe me, if you shout, I can usually tell the difference. So the louder you yell doesn't always help. But that being said, this time I'd like to recognize the town clerk. Oh, yes, thank you. I forget I live in the digital age, I'm a dinosaur. Could we all turn our, please put your cell phones off or on vibrate. I'd appreciate that as well. And so why I'm at it, I forget here. If you are going to be recognized and speak, you can either go to the front here or to the center. Please state your name, and then you'll be recognized to speak. Please use the microphone so that everyone can hear you. All right, this time I'll recognize the town clerk.
Good evening. Before I read the warrant, I would just like to remind the people that are not here and will be watching us on television or cable access later on that tomorrow is the deadline to register to vote. If you wish to vote at our June 13th annual town election, I will be in my office until 4:30 tomorrow, and the registrars will be available in the Dudley Police Station foyer until 8 p.m. And the election will begin at 8 a.m. on Monday, June 13th, and the polls will close at 8 p.m. Thank you. To either of the constables in the town of Dudley and the county of Worcester, greetings. In the name of the Commonwealth of Massachusetts, you are hereby directed to notify and warn the inhabitants of the town of Dudley, qualified to vote in elections and town affairs, to meet in the Shepherd Hill Regional High School Auditorium in said Dudley on Monday, May 23rd, 2016, and Tuesday, May 24th, 2016, if needed, and other such times as may be voted, if needed, at 7 o'clock p.m., then and there to take action on the following articles.
Chair moves with respect to the reading of the articles. Hearing no objections, so moved.
You are hereby directed to serve this warrant by posting attested copies thereof at the Dudley Municipal Center and on the Town of Dudley website, and by posting notice of availability of the warrant on one cable access channel. Warn to be posted at least 7 days before holding of said meeting. Hereof, fail not and make due return of this warrant with your doing thereon to the town clerk at the time of holding of said meeting. Given under our hands this third day of May in the year 2016, Stephen Sullivan, Chairman, John Marcy, Vice Chairman, Peter Fox, Clerk, Paul M. Joseph, and Jonathan Ruta, Dudley Board of Selectmen. I have notified and warned the inhabitants of the town of Dudley by posting up attested copies of the same at the Dudley Municipal Center on the 4th of May, 2016, and Shepherd Hill Regional High School on the 4th of May, 2016. I also observed it posted on the town's website and notice of availability on the Dudley Cable Access Channel on the 4th of May, 2016, thereby making my return to the Dudley Town Clerk on the 6th of May, 2016, Theodore Barron, Sr., Constable, Town of Dudley.
Thank you. Article 1, to see if the town will vote to receive the reports of the several town officers and all committees, take any other action relative thereto. I'll recognize the chairman of the FAA.
The FAA recommends we approve Article 1 as printed in the warrant, and I so move.
It's a motion and a second. Is there any discussion? Seeing none, all those in favor, please state aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, nay. The ayes have it, unanimous. Article 2, to hear and act on the recommendations of the Board of Selectmen and the Finance and Appropriation Advisory Committee, take any other action relative thereto. Chair recognizes the FAA.
The FAA recommends that we approve Article 2 as printed in the warrant, and I so move.
It's a motion and a second. Is there any discussion? Seeing none, we'll call a vote. All those in favor, please state aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, nay. The ayes have it, unanimous. Thank you. If you just walked in, if you could please have a seat and remove your hat, please. Thank you. Article 3, to see if the town will vote to establish and authorize for fiscal year 2017 revolving funds established pursuant to the provisions of Chapter 44, Section 53E and 1/2 of the Massachusetts General Laws. Said funds to be received by the town treasurer and credited to the said revolving fund, and said funds to be dispersed by the town accountant to offset the cost of each fund. In no case shall disbursements exceed the lesser of the sums received during the year or the amount allowed under the provisions of the aforementioned general law. Total expenses not to exceed the amount listed by each fund as noted below. I'll recognize the accounts as written in the article and recognize the FAA.
The FAA recommends that we approve Article 3 as printed in the warrant, and I so move.
There's a motion and a second. Is there any discussion? Yes.
Ken Vitkevich, 20 Brentwood Drive, Precinct 1. I was wondering if this could be amended and adding the recycling transfer fees added to the revolving account to help pay off the yearly budget of $136,590.
What were you looking to amend?
Adding the recycling and transfer fees to the revolving account.
Just going to check with town council to see if that does not exceed the scope of the article. Notice was given that we were setting up revolving accounts, however, that was not one of them. So I just want to make sure that's the case. If it's allowable within the scope, I have no problem amending it. However, if it's not, then I won't be able to accept it. Just give me a moment.
Okay.
Thank you. Unfortunately, because it was not in this warrant article, it's outside of the scope. We can only amend the accounts that are within the article themselves.
I appeal the form the ruling of the moderator. Someone else, I need a second for the appeal. Seeing none, thank you.
Thank you. Is there any further discussion on the motion on the floor to pass the article, as written? Seeing none, we'll call a vote. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, nay.
Nay.
The ayes have it by majority vote. Article 4, to see if the town will accept General Law Chapter 60, Section 15B, which allows the town to establish a tax title collection revolving funds for the treasurer-collector. Said funds to be received by the town treasurer and credited to the said revolving fund, and in no case shall disbursements exceed the lesser of the sums received during the year or the amount allowed. Total expense not to exceed $75,000. Take any other action relative thereto. Excuse me, the chair will recognize the FAA.
The FAA recommends that we approve Article 4 as printed in the warrant, and I so move.
There's a motion and a second. Is there any discussion? Seeing none, we'll call a vote. All those in favor, please state aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, nay. The ayes have it, unanimous. If you've just walked in, I'm just going to ask that you take a seat, please. Thank you. Article 5. To see if the town will vote to raise and appropriate, borrow, or transfer from available funds a sum of $10,772.58 to pay unpaid bills of a prior fiscal year, take any other action relative thereto. Treasurer has a bill from Mega Property Group for $3,491 on the 2015 invoice. Town Hall, WGL Energy Systems, $6,249.08 for 2015 invoice. Wiring Inspector, Assistant Wiring Inspector Aldo Noel, $1,032.50 for past services, 2015 invoices. Chair recognize the FAA.
The FAA recommends that we approve Article 5 as printed in the warrant, with the funding source to be a transfer from free cash, account 001-000-3590-01, and I so move.
It's a motion and a second. Is there any discussion? Seeing none, I'll call the vote. All those in favor, please state aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, nay. The ayes have it, unanimous. Article 6. To see if the town will vote to transfer from available funds from the below passed articles to reduce the fiscal 2016 snow deficit account in the amount of $8,938.16. The chair will recognize the warrant article as written, and I shall recognize the FAA.
The FAA recommends that we approve Article 6 as printed in the warrant, and I so move.
There's a motion and a second. Is there any discussion? Seeing none, we'll call a vote. All those in favor, please state aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, nay. The ayes have it, unanimous. Article 7. To see if the town will vote to transfer the sum of $1,000 from the arrest warrant services account and the sum of $3,000 from the firearm services revolving fund account to the police overtime account to cover costs incurred during the fiscal year. Take any other action relative thereto. Chair recognizes the FAA.
The FAA recommends that we approve Article 7 as printed in the warrant, and I so move.
So motion and a second. Is there any discussion? Seeing none, we'll call a vote. All those in favor, please state aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, nay. The ayes have it, unanimous. Article 8, to see if the town will vote to raise and appropriate, borrow, or transfer from available funds a sum of $23,000 to fund one-third of the cost of the triennial recertification of real estate and personal property values for fiscal year 2018, as required by the Commonwealth Department of Revenue. Chair, recognize the FAA.
The FAA recommends that we pass over Article 8, and I so move.
So motion and a second. Is there any discussion? Seeing none, we'll call the vote. All those in favor, please state aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, nay. The ayes have it, unanimous. Article 9, to see if the town will amend the Town of Dudley Employee Handbook under Benefits, Section 8J, as follows. Please note the proposed text is the text with bold lettering denoting the new text and the strikeouts indicating the deleted text. At this time, I'll recognize the chair of the FAA.
The FAA recommends that Article 9 be passed over, and I so move.
Excuse me. If you could just add the words as written, I would appreciate that on the motion.
The FAA recommends that Article 9 be passed over as written, and I so move.
Thank you. There's a motion. Is there a second?
Second.
I have a motion and a second. Is there any discussion? Seeing none, we'll call the vote. All those in favor, please state aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, nay. The ayes have it. Unanimous vote. Article 10. To see if the town will vote to determine the sums of money the town will raise and appropriate, borrow, or transfer from available funds to defray the charges and expense of the town and provide for a reserve fund, determining the compensation for elected offices and including debt and interest for the ensuing year beginning on July 1st, 2016, or take any other action relative thereto. You'll see that this is your town budget. There is an Appendix A, which breaks this down into further detail. However, I'm going to go down by each department and read the budget. We do this every year, very similar. As I read the item, if you think that's something you'd want to discuss, I just ask that you yell out question, and then I'll mark that. I will then present the chairperson of the FAA to get a motion and a second, and then we can have some discussion on the ones that we have for question at that time. Accountant, $64,819. Animal control, $14,558. Assessors, $97,312. Building and grounds, $137,315. Building inspector, $55,078.27. Cemetery commission, $1,200. Clerk, town, $101,818. Collector is combined with the treasurer. Conservation, $7,808.49. Council on Aging, $102. Emergency management, $1,000. Economic Development Committee, $100. FAA, $10,699.45. Fire Department, $929,269.79. Health, $35,381. Highway, $829,614.28. Historical Commission, $650. Information Technology, $15,110. Inspectors, Sealer of Weights, $2,501. Library, $280,528.89. Moderator, $1. get it all out now, I suppose. Yeah. Well, I'm not going to say you get what you pay for, but I think I'm okay. Municipal expenses, $246,161. Parks, $0.
Question.
Thank you. Personnel board, $650. Planning board, $43,226.90. Police, $1,272,641. Recycling, $136,950. Selectmen, $138,544. Thank you. Town administrator, $127,238. Treasurer collector, $2,739,348. Tree warden, $9,500. Veteran services, $126,109. Zoning Board of Appeals, $3,077.32, for a total general fund of $7,427,951.39. Schools, Dudley Charlton Regional School District, $7,259,813. Southern Worcester County Regional Vocational, $812,386. Total education of $8,072,199. Enterprise funds. Water Department, $986,173.07. Sewer Department, $1,002,972.35. Total enterprise fund of $1,989,146.05 for a total town budget of $17,489,297. At this time, I'll recognize the FAA.
The FAA recommends that we approve Article 10 as printed in the warrant, with the sources of funds as noted in the warrant, and I so move.
We have a motion. Is there a second? Yes, thank you. Okay, I'm going to go back to the first question. I heard someone ask about parks. You should have sat on that aisle seat.
Ken Bukiewicz, Brentwood Drive, Precinct 1. I just want to... Parks and Recreation is zero funded. That means the beach is closed. No lifeguards.
I'm going to recognize the town administrator if you want.
That's fine.
Okay. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to cut you off if I did.
Pardon me?
I didn't mean to cut you off if I did. I'm sorry.
I'm sorry.
I didn't know if you were done speaking. I didn't mean to cut you off if I did.
No, that's fine. The administrator may speak. I yield the floor.
Thank you.
Good evening. My name is Greg Deliaconis, the town administrator. To answer Mr. Bukiewicz's question, money was approved for the town beach in the fall, so the beach will be fully operational as it was last year, open 32 hours a week, Thursday through Sunday. There's no need to include money in this year's budget because it was approved as part of the warrant article last fall, and those monies carry over for use this summer.
Just a question.
Yes.
What is the amount the administrator is providing for Parks and Recreation?
Go ahead.
I don't have the number exactly, but my recollection was somewhere in the range of about $7,000.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. And Mr. Sullivan, you had a question regarding the selectmen's budget.
More of a comment than a question. It's funny, you get a dollar and the five of us get nothing. We get zero, so in that line item.
Well, if you work a little harder, maybe you'll get a raise.
Make a motion to bring Article 20 out of order.
Okay, so. Yes. Yes. Go ahead. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Moderator. Ladies and gentlemen, the budget that you have before you is $17,489,297. I'm pleased to report it's a balanced budget. It addresses the town's needs. It addresses the needs of our enterprise funds and also the schools. At this time, good news is we didn't use any stabilization fund or other monies to balance the budget, and that's a step in the right direction for the town. The overall budget increase is about 1.5%. So if you go through and you go through all the detail on the budget that was available, you'll see that there are some budgets that increased and there are other budgets that offset and went lower, but the bottom line increase is about 1.5%, which I think is pretty good compared to what you see other towns going through right now, and that really required the cooperation of all of our municipal departments and schools to get to that number, and I want to
thank them for their effort because it doesn't happen by accident. Thank you.
Thank you. If you just happen to come in, if you could please find a seat, I'd appreciate it. Okay, on the floor right now, we have the budget, which has been motioned and seconded, and we've had some discussion. Is there any other discussion regarding the budget? Seeing none, we'll call the vote. All those in favor, please state aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, nay. The ayes have it, unanimous. Article 11. Oh, I'm sorry. Thank you. This time, I just want to recognize Mr. Desto, the superintendent of Dudley Charlton Regional Schools. He'd like to just say a couple words.
Thank you, Mr. Moderator. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for indulging me a few minutes. I am Greg Desto. As Mr. Flynn said, I am the superintendent of the Dudley Charlton Regional School District. And for 10 years before that, many of you may recall, I was the principal of Dudley Middle School and fell in love with the town in those 10 years. I'm actually a resident of Charlton, but no joke, my backyard is in Dudley. I'm serious. So while I eat and sleep in Charlton, when I go out on the deck to have a cold drink, I'm in Dudley. And so I think it would be appropriate if I thank you all for letting me unwind in your town for the past 16 years. But seriously, the reason that I wanted to come up here tonight is on behalf of the Dudley Charlton Regional School Committee and the entire district, I want to thank the town administrator, the Board of Selectmen, and the Finance Committee for working with us as they have throughout the course of the year. If you read the newspaper, you see that the kind of collaborative relationship we have is not shared in all places, and I'm grateful for that. And our school committee is grateful for that. You know, the kids in this town, who I would put up against any kids in the world as being as good as any, while a great many of them will go away for college and will maybe stay away for a little while, the largest percentage of them are going to come back, and they are going to be the people sitting in these seats in 10, 15, 20, 25 years. So they really are the future of our community. And I want to thank everybody for working with us to invest in them, because it really is an investment in the town of Dudley. Because I only get to do this once a year, I also want to take a minute to thank Chief Wehner and the Dudley Police Department, Chief Kochanowski and the Dudley Fire Department. Both these guys are great to work with for me, and their cooperation has helped us keep our kids safe throughout the year. We just couldn't do it without their help. Also, quick thanks to Dan Guyon and the Highway Department for all their good work, and certainly in particular in helping us get our schools open for the winter time on those awful, awful mornings when it snows and we're on the phone at 4 a.m. Most of all, I want to thank you, the voters and the townspeople, for supporting our budget and by extension for supporting our kids. We assure you that we're going to keep on doing everything we can to deliver a great school system for your support. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Dunstan. Thank you. Article 11, to see if the town will vote to amend the town bylaws. Article 27, dog control bylaws follows. Amend section 3, license requirements, vaccination fees, exceptions by adding at the end of G, there shall be no license fee for the first or second dog owned by persons age 70 and older as of January 1st of the licensing year. Each additional dog shall be licensed and pay the fee in accordance with this section or take any other action over there too. Chair recognizes the FAA.
The FAA recommends that we approve Article 11 as printed in the warrant, and I so move.
There's a first and a second. Is there any discussion? I recognize the town clerk.
I would just like to ask the selectmen if it's possible to amend this to clarify that this would begin with the licensing year of 2017, since we're already in the process of this licensing year.
Thank you. There's a motion on the floor to amend it. The effective date shall be January 1st, 2017. There's a motion and a second. Is there any discussion regarding that motion? Hearing none, all those in favor, please state aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, nay. The ayes have it. The motion passes for the amendment. Now I'm going to ask for your vote on the article itself. Is there any discussion regarding the article? Hearing none, we'll call the vote. All those in favor, please state aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, nay. The ayes have it, unanimous. Article 12, to see if the town will vote to raise and appropriate, borrow, or transfer from available funds the sum of $18,879 for the purchasing of 10 sets of fire gear, take any other action relative thereto. The chair recognizes the FAA.
The FAA recommends that we pass over Article 12, and I so move.
There's a motion and a second to pass over. Is there any discussion? Yes, Mr. Sullivan.
Just so the people know, this is going to come up in the fall with the blessing of the fire, of the town administrator and fire chief. We are fully committed to public safety. Our guys deserve this equipment. We're going to make sure they get it. Thank you.
Thank you. Is there any other discussion? Seeing none, I'll call the vote. All those in favor, please state aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, nay. The ayes have it, unanimous. Article 13, see if the town will vote to raise and appropriate, borrow, or transfer from available funds the sum of $1,100 to the maturing debt interest account for the interest payment of the rebound of Ambulance 2 or take any other action relative to. Chair recognizes the FAA.
The FAA recommends that we approve Article 13 as printed in the warrant, with the funding source to be by transfer from free cash, account number 001-000-3590-01, and I so move.
There's a motion and a second. Is there any discussion? Seeing none, I'll call the vote. All those in favor, please state aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, nay. The ayes have it, unanimous. Article 14, to see if the town will vote to amend the Dudley General Bylaws by adding the following new article to be numbered Article 49. At this time, I'll recognize the FAA.
The FAA recommends that we approve Article 14 as printed in the warrant, and I so move.
I have a motion and a second. Is there any discussion? Yes.
John Breyer, Flaxfield. I think it's a great bylaw, I mean, well overdue, but the one question I have is under Section 2, veterans, when you're talking about that one section where it says, unless otherwise required by applicable law, the formula to be used for such assessments shall be to equally apportion such costs. Are you talking by owner or by linear foot of road frontage? I just think that needs to be kind of spelled out over there. Because, you know, let's just say you have a neighborhood and you have a farm next to it. Is the farmer going to be paying the entire lineal footage percentage, or is that allocation going to be based upon the actual number of owners of property?
Thank you. Is there someone? Yes, town administrator. Thank you.
I was asked by the Board of Selectmen to address this issue and put together a proposal before you, so it would be equally assessed. It wouldn't be on the basis of linear footage, it would be equally to each property owner that's allowing the way to be improved.
Thank you. Is there any other discussion? Seeing none, we'll call the vote. All those in favor, please state aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, nay. The ayes have it, unanimous. Article 15. See if the town will vote to amend the Dudley General Bylaws, Article 1, Section 1, as follows. The annual town meeting for the adoption of the fiscal budget, we're going to strike various non-financial articles. And other business shall be held, striking the last Monday, adding the Monday preceding Memorial Day in May. And a second session for the consideration of financial articles and other business shall be held, adding this language, held on a Monday in the month of October or November after a public meeting by the Board of Selectmen in June of each year to vote on the date, striking on the first Monday in November unless said Monday is a legal holiday or the following day is a state election, in which case, instead on the preceding Monday. The town meeting shall be held at the town hall or other adequate place to be designated by the Board of Selectmen in the warrant announcing the meeting, take any other action relative thereto. Chair recognizes the FAA.
The FAA recommends that we approve Article 15 as printed in the warrant, and I so move.
So motion and a second. Is there any discussion? Seeing none, we'll call the vote. All those in favor, please state aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, nay. The ayes have it, unanimous. Article 16. This is for large-scale ground-mounted solar photovoltaic installation zoning bylaw amendments. I'm going to add into this language I'm going to ask that it be motioned as written with an exception to an amendment under section 3.1202 applicability, can't pronounce that one tonight, I apologize. I'm only making the buck, I guess. There goes my raise, Mr. Sullivan. Thank God we got rid of the Roman numerals. We're going to strike that language as written and insert the following. This bylaw applies to large-scale ground-mounted solar photovoltaic installations as defined herein, proposed to be constructed with special permits and site plan review, which are applied for after the effective date of this bylaw. I'll recognize the FAA.
The FAA recommends that we approve Article 16 as amended, and I so move.
I think there's a motion and a second. I didn't hear the rest of Mr. Sullivan, I'm sorry. Thank you. Mr. Horn.
Thank you, Mr. Moderator. Guy Horn, Chairman of the Planning Board. The Planning Board held a public hearing on this article, and our recommendation is to approve it with the amendment that you just stated.
Thank you. And while you have it there, Mr. Horn, you held a public hearing? And this, and notice of the public hearing was published in the paper?
Yeah, it was properly advertised.
Thank you. Is there any discussion regarding this? Okay. Seeing none, we'll call the vote. All those in favor, please state aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, nay. Passes unanimously.
As amended.
I'm sorry?
As amended.
As amended, thank you. You passes unanimous as amended. Okay, Article 17. To see if the town will vote to raise and appropriate, borrow, or transfer from available funds a sum of money for dam inspections and phase one reports for Peter Pond Dam and Carpenter Pond Dam as required by the Massachusetts Office of Dam Safety or take any other action relative thereto. Chair recognizes the FAA.
The FAA recommends that we approve Article 17 to transfer transfer from free cash account number 001-000-3590-01 the sum of $2,800 and from DAM's account number 0001-156-5290-02 the sum of $3,600 for a total of $6,400 for the purposes of this article, and I so move.
There's a motion and a second. Is there any discussion? Hearing none, we'll call a vote. All those in favor, please state aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, nay. The ayes have it, unanimous. Article 18, to see if the town will vote to raise and appropriate, borrow, or transfer the sum of $30,000 for the purchase of a new digital signboard to be displayed in front of the Dudley Municipal Complex. Take any other action relative thereto. Chair recognizes the FAA.
The FAA recommends that Article 18 be passed over, and I so move.
Is a motion and a second. Is there any discussion? Seeing none, we'll call the vote. All those in favor, please state aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, nay.
Nay.
The ayes have it by majority vote. Article 19, to see if the town will vote to raise and appropriate, borrow, or transfer from available funds the sum of $225,000 for the purchase and equipping of 5 police cruisers over the next 5 fiscal years commencing in fiscal year 2017 and authorize the treasurer with the approval of the Board of Selectmen to issue bonds or notes that may be necessary for the purposes therein, pursuant to Massachusetts General Law 44, Section 7, or any enabling authority. However, said appropriations shall be contingent on passage of a debt exclusion ballot question on a so proposition 2.5 as provided in Massachusetts General Laws Chapter 59, Section 21CK, or take any other action relative thereto. Chair will recognize the FAA.
The FAA would like to amend Article 19 by changing the number of police cruisers from 5 to 3 and the amount from $225,000 to $135,000, with the funds to come from borrowing. So we'd like to approve Article 19 as amended, and I so move.
I have a motion. Is there a second? There's a motion and a second. Open up for discussion. Chief Wainer. Right ahead.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I was afraid I'd come down here so you didn't have to look at my back as I'm standing up there. This was kind of something we put on very late in the process, and what the idea is that every year we're trying to replace police cruisers. Right now I have about 9 of them in the fleet. Of those 9, 5 of them are either at 100,000 miles or some are well beyond that. I have one that's still in use since 2003. It's about 13 years old and getting very tired. So the problem we're having is these things are, transmissions are going on them of the, I got replaced 3 transmissions of these cars. One of them has been sitting in a garage waiting for a new engine right now. The plan we're trying to do is get on a yearly rotation and bring these vehicles in one at a time coming through the years. And so the problem we have right now is we have to bypass all the funding in the budget to pass it as we just did a few moments ago. And I'm just trying to secure some additional funding in order to get that purpose done each year, so that we don't have to wait till the fall and come in and try to see if there's any available money to buy these cars. The longer we wait, the more mileage gets on these vehicles, the more wear and tear that goes. My maintenance costs this year are around $25,000. That's pretty much 2/3 of the cost of a new car. So all this is trying to do is establish the fact that we can rotate one vehicle a year in through a debt exclusion vote. The impact, as my understanding from the finances, is about $11 on the average home through the course of the year to cover about $45,000. In the total budget operating costs. So that's the whole plan here. Hopefully if we pass this tonight, this goes through, then it has to go to a debt exclusion vote, which will be on the ballot come June 13th at the town election. And I'll gladly answer any questions if anybody has anything on these more info.
Thanks. Is Mr. Bryan there?
Chief, do you need 5 cars or 3 cars?
At this point, we had a discussion with the Board of Selectmen, so it's been lowered down from 5 to 3, so I'm fine with the amendment as it is. At least to start getting us going in the process.
Thank you. Go ahead, Mr. Spall, go ahead. Just come on down to the mic as you're already making your way.
Mike Spall, Mason Earl Dudley. Now, Chief, I'm wondering, when was the last time you got a new cruiser?
We had bought one about a year and a half ago. So we have one that's in, it's a 2016 Explorer. So that was bought, I believe, in 2015. So we're on to that one. But the one before that was bought in 2013. We had actually bought a used car. I don't know if you can recall that. We were able to find a used car. We bought one of those. We bought an unmarked car that we're using right now through the fleet. So we were able to buy one back in 2015. But before that was about a year and a half before that.
Why hasn't the town allowed you to buy a new cruiser every year?
I don't know if it's allowing. I think it's more or less a matter of funding. And you know how it is when it comes up to a fall town meeting or something, if we're waiting for free cash, it's kind of hard to say, give me a third of your free cash so I can go buy cars. And we also have highway vehicles, ambulances, other capital purchases that we have to make, and then in addition, putting money back into the budget. So what I'm trying to do by this is at least set aside some funding that could be used for this purpose that is not a major impact on the finances of the town, but also it allows that free cash in the fall to be used other places for other things.
Again, we as taxpayers, we're paying for this oversight because the town of Dudley did not allow you to buy cruisers. on a timely basis. And now the wear and tear is wearing out your old ones. As you said, you got 10 or 13 of them. Some of them are 13 years old.
Yes, we have the 2003 in there. But it predated me as chief.
That's a shame. This should have been, like any business, this should have been a yearly purchase. At least one cruiser a year. It should have been passed by the FAA, the Board of Selectmen, and you should have pushed for the budget.
Well, I think that's the plan, but all the time, you understand how the finances here are in town, where it's very tight, and so we try to work it through. We have a fund that we can use to help raise some of the money, similar to what the ambulance revenues do, to generate a revolving fund, so we have helped to offset some of the costs, and we try to buy them when we can. So I guess I'm just trying to solve a long-term problem here with getting something that's a stable, set financial package.
What this is a three-year fix.
Excuse me?
Three-year fix.
Basically 3 years, but it buys us time. So we'll hope we're going to have to address it one way or the other, so at least this will get us for 3 years up the line.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I'm Terry Canty, Center Road. I would just like to echo what our previous speaker had to say. I think that this should be part of your budget and that we shouldn't be looking for a Prop 2.5 override in order to secure the safety of our police officers who lay their lives on the line for us on a daily basis. I don't think that this is the way to do it. I strongly feel you should have cruisers. I feel very strongly about that, but not through a Prop 2.5 override. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Is there any other discussion? Thank you. Yes, Mr. Fox.
Peter Fox, 12 Ridge Drive, member of the Board of Selectmen. I very, very much urge you to pass this article. For years, the Capital Improvement Committee, which I am a board member of, has tried to set up a program where we have capital fundings that will support a police cruiser, one a year, which would satisfy the police department. For the past several years, the police chief has gone before the Capital Improvement Committee with their requests, as well as fire department has requests, the highway department has requests, but the Capital Improvement Committee, as of today, and as of 2 years ago, has no money to fund those requests. So the chief is getting himself backed up against the wall. We have to support our police department. We have to give them the tools to do our job and keep our town safe. We owe it to the police chief, and we owe it to the police department to pass this article.
Thank you. Mr. Joseph?
Paul Joseph, 42 Airport Road, Selectman. I just want to be sure people understand this is not a Prop 2.5 override. A Prop 2.5 override is permanent, it's forever. The request is for a Prop 2.5 debt exclusion, which means when the borrowing of the money is paid back, that goes away. It's not still part of the tax rate, it ceases to be. All right, so that folks know, override permanent, debt exclusion, temporary until the debt is paid off.
Thank you, Mr. Joseph. Is there any other discussion? Seeing none, I'm going to call the vote. I'm going to ask for a standing vote. This is a two-thirds majority vote because it is a borrowing. So to avoid, hopefully, confusion, I'm going to ask that if you are voting in the affirmative. Yes, Mr. Joseph.
This still requires a vote by ballot. That's even if it passes here, right?
That's correct. Now, Mr. Joseph would like me to clarify that this tonight allows this to get onto the ballot, which still then requires a majority vote at the annual town election on June 13th. So by voting for this tonight, if you vote in the affirmative, it puts it on the ballot. Is there another question? Can you please approach the microphone, please, so we can hear you? Thank you.
Bob Hill, 15 Southbridge Road. Dudley,
The article is to amend to three?
That's correct. The motion on the floor is for three cruisers and the borrowing of $135,000. Thank you. And if any other questions before I call the vote? Okay, again, I'm going to ask if you're standing in the back to kindly have a seat. Oh, thank you very much. I appreciate it. Thank you. I don't want to get you confused with everybody else. Thank you. So if you are in the affirmative, please stand. Thank you. I believe that's two-thirds vote. The motion passes as amended by two-thirds vote.
Thank you very much.
Article 20. Article 20 is going to be amended. And I guess I will give the explanation now. We are going to read the article and approve it, read the article for approval and a motion up until the words Board of Selectmen on line 11 as printed. The remaining portion as printed deals with a debt exclusion. And you are not allowed as a town to vote on a debt exclusion without an amount certain. And at this point in the process for this particular parcel, an amount certain has not been presented to the Board of Selectmen via 61A. So as a result, that cannot be voted on tonight. I'm going to have the motion read, presented, and if it's seconded, I'll give you a further commentary at that time. I recognize the FAA.
Mr. Moderator, would you like me to...
If you could just read, in this case for me, I'd appreciate it. Actually, yes, if you could just read up until... Actually, I'll read it. I apologize. It's my fault. So, pardon me. So the Article 20, to see if the town will vote to authorize the Board of Selectmen to exercise its right of first refusal under the provisions of Massachusetts General Law, Chapter 61A, Section 14, and to acquire by purchase, gift, or eminent domain three parcels of land located on Corbin Road in Dudley, the first parcel containing approximately 2 acres, and the second parcel containing approximately 48 acres, and the third parcel containing approximately 5.1 acres. All said parcels are shown on a plan titled Perimeter Plan of Land, surveyed for Charles and Annabelle Amaninski, dated December 14, 2004, and further shown on the Town of Dudley Assessor's Map 210, Parcel 17, a copy of said plan on file with the town clerk, property to be used for municipal purposes and or agricultural purposes, including leasing the property to third party on terms and conditions deemed acceptable to the Board of Selectmen. I recognize the FAA.
The FAA recommends that Article 20 be approved as read, and I so move.
There's a motion and a second. Thank you. So before we open up for discussion, I just want everybody to know, and I believe the selectmen will probably address this further with you, that what you are voting for tonight is essentially a reaffirmation of the selectmen's powers if application is provided under Chapter 61A to exercise a right of first refusal. The selectmen already possess that power to do so without your vote. However, they are looking for a reaffirmation tonight and going forward. A application under 61A has not been presented to the selectmen as of yet, and this is not a binding vote. This is simply a reaffirmation. I'm going to recognize Mr. Sullivan. However, I will take any questions to that as best I can answer them, or town council can answer them, or the selectmen can. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Moderator. Just a little bit more history. The Board of Selectmen put that article in as like a placeholder. We were anticipating we'd have an offer in hand, a copy of which would be provided. It has not been provided. town administrator and council asked for it in writing. We have not received it yet. And on the town council's recommendation, we're amending it as the moderator stated because there's no amount to be ruled out of order. Under statute, we have the authority, 61A, to consider purchasing any land that's in 61A. So we're asking people to accept the motion as amended and trust the process going forward.
Thank you. Is there any further discussion? Seeing none, we'll call the...
Simple majority, right?
Yes, this is a simple majority. So, are you looking to be recognized? Do you have a comment? Thank you.
Susan James, Corbin Road. I want to know if we're voting for a very general affirmation of the selectmen's right to exercise this power of
That's what it is.
Or does it have anything specific to do with the lots on Corbin Road?
Does it
apply just to those? Does it apply to those lots on Corbin Road, or is it very general?
This applies to the lots on Corbin Road. That's what's in the motion. The power itself is a general power that the selectmen have, and they're looking for reaffirmation of that power. But again, it's not binding.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome. Yes?
Mrs.
Rossin, if you could kindly just move to the mic, I'd appreciate it. I know you, but you can't get special privilege here. Please don't flunk my children. I haven't earned it tonight.
Good evening, I'm Cindy Rossin. I live on Cardinal Drive in Dudley. And I have just a question about property to third terms. What would specify conditions for leasing?
Again.
Because it says here that we're actually voting to give the right to purchase the land, and then the selectmen have the right to determine what appropriate leasing
right.
is or not.
So
what could leasing be?
Right.
What are some guidelines before?
Right. So again, what happens is, and what Mr. Sullivan had explained was, this was sort of an anticipation that the town was going to be presented with an application under 61A, which would then require some approvals. However, because that was not done, tonight was just simply a reaffirmation vote. The selectmen have all these powers to do this already in terms of dealing with 61A if it comes about at the appropriate time.
May I ask one more question for clarification?
Absolutely.
Who determines what it can be leased for?
The selectmen will determine that.
Without a public vote?
Without a public vote, because they have the power to do so, under 61A.
That makes me uncomfortable, quite honestly. I think this is something
Unless I'm mistaken, Mr. Bragg.
Do it as a town.
Thank you. Yeah, the selectmen, under Massachusetts general law, have the power to do many things with town property that they don't have to come to town meeting for. And one of those under 61A is the ability to exercise a right of first refusal, negotiate a purchase and sale contract with a potential seller under terms that they see adequate. That is usually done after a full public hearing on the event, so they'll take that into consideration at that time. So it's not like the town doesn't have any input in the process because it is a public hearing at the 61A
meeting. But no final say. Ultimately.
That's right, it's not a binding proposition at that point. There may be other events further where the town could have some binding, but again, it would only have to come back to town meeting if you needed a debt exclusion
such
or something
as,
like that.
I just want to make sure we're not putting a band-aid on an issue that's certainly...
What you're doing now is simply a reaffirmation, almost a paper vote, if you will. The selectmen already have all these powers, and what you're doing tonight is just reaffirming that for them, a consensus vote, if you will.
Do we have an option?
An auction of the property?
An option to say we would like to have some say in what happens.
I don't believe so.
There is no legal ground for the people to speak.
Again, anything outside of the purview of this motion, I really don't want to answer. I don't know that part of it, but what you're getting into is a lot of questions regarding 61A, which aren't really applicable tonight, unfortunately. What is applicable tonight is that we have a vote before us regarding the reaffirmation of the selectmen's powers of right of first refusal under that.
Thank you for answering
that. Yes, and I can recognize, excuse me, I'll recognize Attorney Brackett, so he can address some of this for you as well, Mrs. Rossman.
Mr. Moderator, members of town meeting, I just want to point out that within the motion that was read, there's a statement that the property is to be used for municipal purposes and or agricultural purposes. So if the property, if in fact the selectmen were to exercise this right, they would have to come back to town meeting for funding. And at the time of funding, which requires a two-thirds vote, the appropriation to actually acquire the land, either under 61A or as is provided, a purchase gift to eminent domain. At the time that presentation is made, the selectmen would make a presentation as to the municipal purpose for which the funding would be sought.
Thank you. I recognize Mr. Sullivan.
Upon speaking with the town administrator, as it says in the article, the general property to be used for municipal purposes and or agricultural purposes. Our intent as a board, if this ever comes to fruition, would be to look for agriculture first through a lease. Everybody knows it was local farmers that spoke out at some of the public hearings that there would be some interest. That would be our first and most desirable option, agriculture.
Thank you. Yes, approach the microphone, please. Thank you.
My name is, Walter Spiewalkowski. I'm just wanting to know what we're voting for. Are we voting on an article or just a confirmation of the rights they already have? Which is it?
Right, what you're voting on is the article as amended, which is basically the first 11 lines of what you see printed there, which is a reaffirmation, non-binding, of the selectmen's power to, if something comes across at 61A, that they have the right to exercise the right of first refusal.
I just don't understand why we have to vote on something they already have a power to do.
Well, we kind of had that discussion, but I think they're looking for a consensus. Yes, Mr. Breyer, and then right behind you.
Yeah, question more for the legal proceedings here. Because the applicant hasn't, submitted the 61A, you can't do anything, right? The purpose of tonight is if they had shown goodwill and good faith and actually submitted it, we'd be voting on whether or not to accept the offer that was negotiated for a certain price tonight. That's not going to happen. Next time meeting's in the fall. So between now and then, hopefully they'll do the 61A because that's what APR land is supposed to do, give us the right first refusal. During this process between now and fall, technically the applicant doesn't have a legal claim or a right to the property in which they put forth the proposal. So should all public hearings be suspended from now until the time we have a town meeting and decide whether or not to exercise our right under 61A?
I'll try to answer that, and if Mr. Brackett wants to interject, I'll certainly let him. Basically, the applicant under 61A is actually the seller of the property. The seller is not bound by any time limit to bring forth an application under 61A until they may see fit. They are required, and that's our belief as the town, that they are required to do so, to present that to the Board of Selectmen. At which time the Board of Selectmen has a certain process that they must follow by statute. There's time limits and dates which get into the amount of time they have to enter into a contract and do due diligence, things of that nature. But until such time that happens, they're under no requirement to do so. I'm not sure if you're referring to applicant under other public hearings, meaning the other part of it, meaning the buyer of the property, so to speak. They're under no obligation to do anything in the 61A at this point in time because it doesn't fall upon them, it falls upon the seller. Yes, you have to follow up, that's fine.
So I mean, I guess that's the question is, we have the right of first refusal.
That's correct.
They sold or under contract with a third party to purchase that, does not make that null and void?
No, it does not. No, they have the right of first refusal, which the selectmen have the power, but they have rights as well, which they then have to have a public hearing and everything else in regard to that. And the selectmen, after public hearing, can then make up their mind to determine that. They have that power to do so. Again, this was put on tonight, I believe, as Mr. Sullivan had said, in anticipation that that was going to happen and be prepared. Because you are correct, it will take time. Depending on the time frame, it may have to be other meetings or a special town meeting or something to that effect, if that's the way it goes. Again, no one knows that at this point in time, how that will play out. So they were trying to be as prepared as possible to do so. Understanding that it did not come in, can't vote on the debt exclusion. However, they were looking for a consensus vote, which is essentially what this is tonight. Does that satisfy everything for you, Mr. Brown? Thank you. Mr. Canty.
Mr. Moderator, Ken Canty, 30 Center Road, Dudley, Mass. Is the Board of Selectmen going to seek affirmation every time a parcel of farmland is being sold? Or is it simply when there's a religious society seeking to purchase that property?
These people are recognized. Mr. Sullivan?
Just for the record, I've been a selectman for approximately 10 years, planning board 4 years. The town, best of my knowledge, has never purchased 61A, but clearly our last couple of times, my board members can back me up, we did not exercise our right. We clearly stated for the record that just because we didn't do it then doesn't mean we wouldn't do it in the future. And actually, when I was on the planning board, the development Mr. Desco was referring to, that abuts Dudley, some of you folks might know that the trail through there, Old Mason Road, it's a trail that cuts parallel to his Pierpont. The applicant gave us 7 acres. We're supposed to hold a lot back in reserve that they have to offer to us. It's convoluted, believe me. That's why I'm not on the planning board. But we negotiated the 7-acre parcel. But I guess the short answer to the previous speaker is we have not purchased 61A to the best of my knowledge. And every piece of parcel that comes forward is a case-by-case basis. If somebody would come forward and offer us something that may be suitable for a school, for example, I'm sure it's something the town would look at. If it's a water source, I'm sure it's something the town would look at. So the best I can say is everyone is a case-by-case basis, and I think the rest of the board will back me up on that.
Thank you. Thank you. I'm going to recognize Mr. Brackett. I think he has something to just like to add to the process.
Mr. Moderator, I just want to clarify 2 points in response to questions raised from the audience. The article seeks not only authorization under Chapter 61A, for which there is statutory authority to the selectmen, but it also seeks approval for the purchase, sale, or eminent domain of the parcel. So what we've done is we've set forth within the article 4 methods of possible acquisition. It simply just authorizes the selectmen. It doesn't mandate them to take this action. It authorizes them to pursue any one of those 4. The 61A is already provided by statute. And also, Mr. Breyer asked a question about the current proceedings before the zoning board. The zoning board has held 3 public hearings. The Board of Health has held 1 public hearing to date. I would not recommend to the boards that they stop those proceedings as a result of this current issue. The town administrator has sent notice to Ms. Maninsky at her main address, advising her of her requirements to provide notice under the statute. And we're expecting that she's going to comply with it. She's bound by law to do so. So we will continue to work with the zoning board and the Board of Health on the proceedings that have taken place to this point, while at the same time working with the selectmen on the 61A notice. Thank you.
Thank you. Is there any further discussion? Yes, Mr. Breyer.
And just real quick, for the last question from the audience, the inference there, you should be embarrassed. I was part of the master plan committee, and we developed that master plan, spent thousands of hours, and the town invested tens of thousands of dollars in that master plan. One of the number one focuses of the master plan that was completed in 2003, around that time period, was the preservation of agricultural land in Dudley. Dudley has the second highest agricultural protected land in the state. It is part of our resource. It, you know, when we're looking at where water and sewer runs and this and that, You know, this is one of our number one assets. And I would venture to say, how many pieces of APR land have even come up in the past 10 years? Are we even talking? One or two have even come before us? So this is totally in sync with the master plan and what the residents overwhelmingly voted for to have Dudley be a part of.
Is there any further discussion on the matter? Okay, we'll take a vote. All those in favor for the motion as amended, please state aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, nay. The ayes have it by majority vote. Article 21, to see if the town will vote to amend the zoning bylaws of the town of Dudley, Massachusetts, used by district chart section 2.03.02, as listed below, and the footnotes for use by district chart section 2.03.03, as listed below, take any other action relative thereto. Chair will recognize the FAA.
The FAA recommends that we approve Article 21 as printed in the warrant, and I so move.
There's a motion. Is there a second?
Second.
I have a motion and a second. And this time I'll recognize Mr. Horn.
Thank you, Mr. Moderator. This article is a zoning article. The Planning Board did properly advertise and hold a public hearing, and we voted to approve this article as printed.
Thank you. Is there any further discussion regarding this article? Seeing none, we'll call the vote. All those in favor, please state aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, nay. The ayes have it, unanimous. Article 22, to see if the town will vote to transfer from available funds a sum of $55,000 from the sewer retained earnings account for the purchase and installation of two generators for the Luther Lane Pump Station and Lakeview Ave No. 1 Pump Station, and take any other action relative thereto. Chair recognizes the FAA.
The FAA recommends that we approve Article 22 as printed in the warrant, with the funds coming from a transfer from sewer retained earnings, and I so move.
I have a motion. Is there a second? Motion and a second. Is there any discussion? Seeing none, we'll call the vote. All those in favor, please state aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, nay. The ayes have it, unanimous. Article 23, to see if the town will vote to transfer from available funds a sum of $100,000 from the sewer retained. Sorry about that. I apologize. I didn't check it off. Excuse me. Article 24, to see if the town will vote to transfer the sum of $800,000 from the water retained earnings account to replace the water main, including incidental costs on Mill Street and on Pine Street, or take any other action relative thereto. Chair recognize the FAA.
The FAA recommends that we approve Article 24 as printed in the warrant, with funds coming from a transfer from the water retained earnings, and I so move.
There's a motion and a second. There's a motion. Is there a second? Is there any discussion on the matter? Seeing none, we'll call the vote. All those in favor, please state aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, nay. The ayes have it. Unanimous. Excuse me, just a moment.
Article 23.
Yeah, all right. I'm sorry. I did do our thing. Yeah, I'm sorry. I'm going to go back. I apologize. Forgive me. Yeah, I told you I wasn't going to earn that raise tonight. All right. Article 23. To see if the town will vote to transfer from available funds a sum of $100,000 from the sewer retained earnings account for the purchase of two new pumps and motors for Lakeview Ave No. 1 Pump Station. Take any other action relative thereto. The chair recognizes the FAA.
The FAA recommends that we approve Article 23 as printed in the warrant, with funds coming from a transfer from the sewer retained earnings account, and I so move.
Second.
There's a motion and a second. Is there any discussion? Seeing none, we'll call the vote. All those in favor, please state aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, nay. The ayes have it, unanimous. Article 25, To see if the town will vote to raise and appropriate, borrow, or transfer the sum of $15,000 for the purpose of removing several large and decaying trees and various tree limbs in Corbin Cemetery, take any other action relative thereto. Chair recognizes the FAA.
The FAA recommends that we pass over Article 25, and I so move.
Is a motion? Is there a second? Is a motion and a second? Is there any discussion? Seeing none, we'll call the vote. All those in favor, please state aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, nay.
Nay.
The ayes have it by majority vote. Article 26. To see if the town will vote. On what one? I've just called the vote. Sorry. Article 26. To see if the town will vote to raise an appropriate borrow or transfer the sum of $1,500 for the purchase of a 6-foot rotary motorhead for mowing the capped landfill area or take any other action relative thereto. Chair recognizes the FAA.
The FAA recommends that we pass over Article 26, and I so move.
The motion, the second. Is there any discussion? Chair recognizes the town administrator.
You may ask why we're passing over all these articles. We just don't have the money. So the budget is balanced. There's no available funds unless we use our reserves. As was stated earlier this evening by Chairman Sullivan, these articles will be back in the fall. We have free cash that gets certified, and before we set our tax rate, we will have another town meeting in October or November to address these requests that are being passed over this evening due to the lack of funding. That's the reason why they can't be voted this evening.
Thank you. Is there any other discussion? Seeing none, we'll call the vote. All those in favor, please state aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, nay. The ayes have it. Unanimous decision. Article 27. To see if the town will vote to accept as public ways the layout of Tobin Drive, Nellie's Way, and Stephens Drive, and to further authorize the Board of Selectmen to acquire by purchase, gift, or eminent domain a fee simple or lesser interest in the land within such ways and any easements related thereto, and to raise and appropriate the sum of $1 for the purposes of this article, take any other action relative thereto. Chair recognizes the FAA.
The FAA recommends that we pass over Article 27, and I so move.
The motion is second. I recognize the town administrator.
Thank you. There's a legal process for involvement and acceptance of roads, and it requires the submission of a recommendation of the planning board. The planning board verifies that the improvements have been done on the roadway. There's then an as-built or an acceptance plan that gets submitted to the Board of Selectmen. The Board of Selectmen then hold a public hearing and actually vote to lay out the roadway. And then, once those steps are accomplished, it comes to town meeting to be approved. And to the best of my knowledge, those have not been done. So the fact that there may be individuals who feel that we need to accept the road, there's a legal process that needs to be followed, and we really can't circumvent that by voting at that town meeting.
Thank you. Just a moment, please. I said that's a clarification from the town council, as well as the town administrator, if you both come. I want to confer with town council. I was not aware until at this point in time that the procedure had not yet been followed. There is a legal process that has not been done as of yet. It has to be notified to abutters. It hasn't been done yet. As such, we can't take a vote on the motion because the road cannot be accepted because it has not followed the process. So at this point, I required it necessary to rule it out of order and not be voted on.
Thank you.
Is there a question? I'm sorry. Yes.
Bob McGowan, I live at 12 Toby Drive. Who starts that process?
I defer to the town administrator.
We've been to many meetings. They keep saying, you know, we do everything we're supposed to do, and then it's supposed to come here, and we're supposed to be voted on. Now you're saying nothing's been done.
Excuse me. Please. Wait to be recognized. Thank you. I'm sorry. Sir, your name again, please. I'm sorry.
Paul McGowan.
Paul McGowan? Thank you. Thank you. Mr. Sullivan.
Once again, the Board of Selectmen, we put this in as a placeholder. We knew that the Planning Board was working with the developer of record to get that roadways done. At one point, the developer had a meeting with the town administrator and indicated that he was going to do an as-built plan. He had some excess funds in his account, and would we release the funds for his plan? And to my understanding, he was told, yes, bring the plan, bring a bill, and we will release the funds. He never did that. The process, I can defer to Mr. Horn, the chairman, but I was on the planning board also. The burden now, unfortunately, does not fall on the residents, it does not fall on us, it falls on your developer of record. The planning board, at last year, when you guys got your road paved, and they waived the detention basin, they really worked with the developer to try to get you guys to where you needed to be. And unfortunately, the town administrator or the planning board can't force the developer to finish what he promises to do. And like I said, we put it as a placeholder, just like Article 20. We were expecting all documentation to be provided. I communicate with some of your residents quite regularly, and I promised them we would do that to give you guys at least a chance, and then your developer just didn't come through in the 23rd hour. Sorry.
Thank you.
Thank you. Is there any other discussion, any other questions? Thank you. As I said before, Article 27 is ruled out of order. Article 28, to see if the town will vote to authorize the Board of Selectmen to approve a payment in lieu of taxes agreement for 20 years duration and subject to other terms and conditions negotiated by the town and Nexamp Inc. pursuant to Massachusetts General Law Chapter 59, Section 38H and regulations promulgated thereunder with respect to annual payments in lieu of real and personal property taxes relative to the land located at the intersection of Center Road and Farley Road. Said pilot agreement is based upon the proposed construction and operation of a solar photovoltaic power plant with a capacity of approximately 1.3 megawatts and to take any action relative thereto. Chair, recognize the FAA.
The FAA recommends that we approve Article 28 as printed in the warrant, and I so move.
Second.
There's a motion and a second. Is there any discussion? Seeing none, we'll call a vote. All those in favor, please state aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, nay.
Nay.
The ayes have it by majority vote. Article 29, to see if the town will vote to amend the Dudley General Bylaws by adding the following to be numbered Article 50, to recognize the FAA.
The FAA recommends that we approve Article 29 as printed in the warrant, and I so move.
Second.
There's a motion and a second. Is there any discussion? Yes, Chief Wayne.
Thank you, Mr. Moderator. Just for clarification purposes, this is designed to allow solicitors to register with the police department. So it exempts people like, again, recognized charities, politicians, religious groups. They can still go buy homes and do their solicitations like they normally do. This covers people such as, I'm sure, if I showed for a show of hands, how many people have been visited by a solar company in the last year or so? Okay, so certain companies and certain organizations come through, and in some of our checking on these cases, some people are, I guess we could consider, not of the greatest character. So what we're trying to do is have these people register with the department. If there's individuals that have certain questions, we can deny them from going out and soliciting in the community. They can certainly appeal our decision to the Board of Selectmen and be allowed to go from there. What will basically happen is a person, if they want to register as a hawker and peddler in town, they will come to the police department, they fill out a state application, and I have to sign off on the form, basically checking that they're decent people, of good moral character, as is stated basically in the law. So what we're going to use for a governing point is the same standard. We'll register a person from town who would want to be one of these peddlers. We want to apply the same provision to people who come in from out of town. So this is merely just something to kind of put a checks and balance system on these individuals. And again, if there's any questions, I could certainly answer those. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Chief. Yes. If you could, just through the microphone, please, though, that way we can all hear it. Thank you.
Terry Candy. My question is, how will a resident know that a peddler is approved or not approved as, you know, has checked in with you?
I believe the question was, how would a resident know if they were approved or not approved? Did I summarize that?
Yep.
Thank you.
Yes, I think what we'll plan to do is give them some kind of a letter, but also I would encourage any citizen to call the police department if somebody does approach them, because we're not going to be issuing like identifications or anything of that nature, but if there certainly is a question on anybody, call the police department, we'll know at that point, and then we can send an officer out to check on it from that point. But I believe we'll plan to issue them some type of letter that they've been approved to solicit.
Thank you. Any other questions for the chief or any further discussion? Yes, Mr. Breyer.
On behalf of commercial salespeople, myself, how do you make sure that the commercial world isn't shut down by this regulation? I mean, for instance, you know, you have someone maybe selling services to Gentex or goes down Main Street hitting all the commercial businesses. How do you make sure that they're exempt from this? Understand what you're trying to do here. You know, with the peddlers, but how do we make sure that we don't cross a line?
Yes, Chief Wayne.
It's my understanding this is designed for people who are going to try to solicit sales from residents. I think that's what it is. That's why groups like religious groups, politicians, those types of things, they're trying to come in and sell you something or do whatever. So it's targeted for the individuals who are going out conducting that business. So for example, if somebody wants to come by and say, hey, would you like to buy a home alarm system? They'll come into your house, now they know you don't have an alarm, and they know where some vulnerabilities in your home might be, and so that could be a question that's come forward. So I think for certain companies, if they're trying to bring awareness to something or whatever, that's different. This is more designed for people who are selling articles or wanting to solicit purchases at that point.
Thank you. Any further discussion? Seeing none, we'll call the vote. All those in favor, please state aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, nay. The ayes have it. Unanimous. Article 30. Going to recognize the FAA.
The FAA wishes to...
You defer to the petitioner on this one? No, you guys have it. Okay, thank you.
Yes. The FAA would like to amend Article 30 by striking Section 4 completely. We would like to approve Article 30 as amended, and I so move.
Section 4, thank you. I have a motion on the amended article and a second, and now I have discussion from Mr. Joseph. Oh, sorry.
Moderator, I just would ask simply that that the motion be reconsidered as...
Order of mic, please.
We go with the mic, please. Sure. Thank you.
All I ask is that this be passed properly. If you're going to delete Section 4, I ask that you renumber the subsequent sections as 4 and 5. All right, is that acceptable?
Is that acceptable to your motion?
Yes.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you,
Mr. Moderator.
Thank you.
My name is Paul Wheelock. I live at 28 Center Road, and I'm also president of the Dudley Conservation Land Trust, who's sponsoring this article. When we looked at this article, we looked at all the surrounding towns, and this article is pretty much word for word the same as every other town that we looked at. Oxford, Sutton, Rutland, Barry, Sturbridge. All these other towns have no problem with this section. And my only concern is I would like to refer to town council. Will this article pass muster with the attorney general if this is eliminated?
Go ahead. Yeah. Recognize the FAA. No, 1 second. I'll have you read that.
I'd like to read for you all the first sentence of section 4. In the event of conflict between this bylaw and all other town regulations, this bylaw shall take precedence. That means every other bylaw that we have on the books, this bylaw takes precedence. Our discussions, we had a problem with that. That's why we chose to amend it. That's all.
Mr. Brackett?
Mr. Moderator, the language of the first portion of Section 4, in the event of a conflict between this bylaw and all other town regulations, this bylaw shall take precedence. That's a standard operating procedure that a bylaw would generally have priority over regulations within a town. It would not have priority over another bylaw, but I'm assuming that based upon my review of the town bylaws, this right to farm bylaw is not in conflict with another town bylaw. The remaining language in the event of a conflict between this bylaw, federal or state law shall take precedence respectfully. That also is a matter of priority. So that even without this language, which is being proposed to be stricken by the Finance Committee, I believe that the bylaw would pass approval by the Attorney General's office. And the law of priority, federal law takes priority over state law takes priority over municipal law. That would exist anyway, even without this language.
Thank you.
I'd like to ask that you approve this bylaw. We really, as the gentleman earlier said, agriculture priority in this town. We have over 1,600 acres alone in APR, and most of it is in hay. We need to try and find people to come in and make this land more productive. And with this bylaw, we'd be sending a message that we support them. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. One moment.
I have no problem whatsoever with agriculture. My grandfather was a farmer. I would love to own a farm. There are pieces in this. Believe me, I would love to own a farm. I live on Airport Road. I was actually excited when I saw this. I thought, wow, I could have chickens and things. I could have all sorts of things, Paul, like an emu, a camel. Paul's my neighbor. But that's the only part I have a problem with. Believe me, farms, yay. I stop and I buy farm fresh eggs. My kids love them, don't you? Yeah. I have no problem with farms. That's the only piece. I just have a problem with a bylaw taking precedence over other things. That's all. Yay farms. Thank you.
Thank you. Yes.
Good evening. Stephanie Covino, 38 Marsh Road.
I'm sorry, could you just say that again? I don't think we picked it up.
Sure. Stephanie Covino, 38 Marsh Road.
Thank you.
I just want to echo again what others have said, that, you know, there's a reason why a lot of us live in Dudley, and that's because it's a community that values conservation, and we have a lot of beautiful areas that we get to be around. And I think that this bylaw really speaks to that, and it's going to show those who live in town, as well as those moving into town, that this is an important part of our community of farming. And I was just wondering if you can give an example of where this bylaw, which doesn't do a whole lot, it doesn't have a lot of teeth per se, it's a lot of just saying, you know, we respect farmers, this is important to our community character. Is there an example that you can give that would conflict with this bylaw that you're uncomfortable with? Because when you say that sentence, that it takes precedence, it sounds scary, But if you read the bylaw, there's not a lot in it that really could take over another bylaw and create confusion, at least to my understanding.
Yes, go ahead.
It's not just bylaws that are in place now. What bylaws are going to be in place in the future? I mean, I was born here, raised here. I went to school here. I went to school at Nichols. Dudley has changed immensely over the past few decades. Who knows what's going to happen over the next couple of years? I don't have a problem with this. I think this is a great idea. It's just that little piece of taking precedence. That's all. That's all. I just don't... That is scary. That's the only piece that's scary.
I skipped the 126.
I hope you can understand where I'm coming from. I'm not against this. I'm just against that, piece.
Thank you. I'm going to recognize Mr. Marston.
Let me help you out, Carol. So, again, I'm for this. The amendment of... it's not the conflict of precedence. The thing that I would always have an eye on for is any federal laws that... tell us what to do. It could potentially make some unfunded mandates down the road. I always want to keep things under local control as much as possible. So, but I am for this. Let's please pass this.
I just want to say really quickly again what someone else said. That's pretty standard operating procedure. I don't know another community that's taken that out, but I am certainly for the bylaws a whole, how it was written in this.
Thank you. I recognize Mr. Fox. And then Mr. Joseph. I'll get you to in a moment, Mr. Manager.
One of the greatest drawing cards and features that Dudley has is its open space, its farmland, its horse farms, its cattle. This article has been reviewed by town council, has been discussed. I have no problems with this article whatsoever, and I support it.
Thank you. Mr. Joseph?
Yeah, this is not complicated. Really isn't. Town Council has said that bylaws, any bylaw, takes precedence over regulations. Regulations are not bylaws. What's written in Section 4 applies to all town bylaws, not just this bylaw. When town council says it's okay the way it's written. We can't violate state law. We can't violate federal law. It's okay the way it's written. It's not different from any other bylaw. This one just says it. So I would ask, Mr. Moderator, that you think about asking the mover of the motion to either rescind the motion, or, if that's not appropriate, that we defeat this motion as made, and we entertain a new motion to approve this particular article as written. It is important that we do this for our future and our children's future, for farmland, and to create the kind of community that we really want to create here. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Joseph. Is there anyone else? Yes, Mr. Brandon, thank you. I know we have one more.
Mike Braniff, Lyons Road. The agricultural and farming tradition of Dudley goes back to the very beginning. It's been a powerful presence in Dudley right up until the 40s and 50s. It started to decline after the GI Bill came in touch. Farming became not so important. But it was considered important enough during World War II to have victory gardens, home farms, crops, a really vibrant and a really vibrant connection between the town, its citizens, and this form of agriculture and animal raising. I would say that it's important that this tradition be continued and encouraged as much as possible. And that's what this article tries to do. I am not in favor of amending this article, and
Okay, I'm going to recognize the FAA. Do you want me to?
Yeah, it's the vote of the board.
Okay, thank you. All right, so is there anyone else who wishes to discuss it? Okay, so just procedurally here, so we're all on the same page. What's before you now to be voted on, okay, is the motion written as amended, which removes item number 4. So if you vote in the affirmative, you're going to vote on it as it's amended. If you do not want the amended version of this motion, you need to vote in the negative. Any questions on that? Okay. If it's defeated, which judging by all the clapping, I'm assuming it's going to be, you can then re-raise the motion as it's written and we'll take a vote on that form of the motion. Okay, again, any other questions with that? Any clarification needed? Okay, so I'm going to call the vote. All those in favor of the motion as amended, please state aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, nay.
Nay.
The nays have it by majority vote. The motion is amended. I recognize the gentleman.
Paul Wheelock, I'd like to make a motion that we vote to approve the article as written.
So motion and a second. I'll entertain any discussion if there is anything further at this point. Seeing none, we'll call the vote. All those in favor, please state aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, nay. The ayes have it by majority vote. So thank you. I'm going to assume that clapping is for me for explaining all that. I think I got my dog right. I have reached. Okay, Article 31. I have a petition article. Is the petitioner here?
Mr. Moderator, it's a the article is a zoning article. The planning board did have a properly advertised public hearing on the article. And at the public hearing, we were advised by town council to make a modification.
Yes.
To section 313.02 applicability, which currently states, this bylaw applies to all new cemeteries as defined herein, proposed to be constructed after the effectivity date of this bylaw. Town council's recommendation was to strike the effectivity date of this bylaw and simply put in the date of September 1st, 2016, so that this particular article would not interfere with the current situation with the currently pending cemetery that's under review by the Zoning Board of Appeals.
Thank you. September 1st, 2016. So I'll entertain your motion.
And the planning board recommends this article be approved with the amendment recommended by town council to add the September 1st, 2016 as a starting date.
Okay, I have a motion on the article written as amended on the floor. Is there a second? I have a second. I'm going to open it up to any discussion. Yes.
Richard Raymond, Corbin Road. What would be the purpose of September 1st versus tonight?
I'm going to have Mr. Hornet explain that a little bit, but I'm going to have town council come up and talk to the change in the effective date. I'm sorry, can I just get your last name again? I'm sorry, sir, for the record.
I'm sorry, I'll stay standing until I get the answer. Raymond, last name is Raymond.
Thank you. Thank you. Mr. Bradford.
Mr. Moderator, members of town meeting, under the provisions of Mass General Laws, Chapter 48, Section 5, a zoning bylaw is considered to be effective as of the date of adoption, which would be tonight. There is currently pending the application for the cemetery on Corbin Road before the Zoning Board, which, as I indicated earlier, has already held 3 public hearings and is prepared to continue its deliberations on June 2nd. When I spoke with the petitioners about this article and also members of the planning board, it was my understanding that they did not intend
that this proposed bylaw would affect the application that's currently pending before the Zoning Board of Appeals. And for that reason, I included the language to propose an effective date of September 1st rather than tonight if it's voted, so as to allow that application before the Zoning Board to continue under the zoning bylaw in place at the time it was filed.
So is it best for the residents of Dudley to understand this is to avoid any possibility of appeals and lawsuits?
I'm sorry, I didn't hear that completely.
Is this being amended to avoid any further action that may be negative to the town of Dudley?
Well, the intent of the petitioners was clearly not to address the pending application. But I explained to them what the effective date was. And the reason that that's important is because some of the bylaws that we've adopted tonight, the general bylaws, those are not effective until they're approved by the Attorney General's office, which generally takes 90 days or more. And then once they're approved and they're posted, they become effective. Zoning bylaws, even if it takes 90 days for review and approval, are effective retroactive to the date of adoption. So when I explained that to the Planning Board, the intention was not to have this proposed bylaw affect the current application.
Thank you for the explanation.
You're welcome.
Thank you. Yes, Mr. Bryan.
A question for town council. You know, again, Mass General Law Chapter 114, Section 35 clearly states that the only authority that can approve the use of any land right for a cemetery is DEP first. DEP has to bless the land first. So is it possible that we can say, you know, with this new bylaw, that before an applicant even goes down that path, they need to provide in hand the approval from 114 Section 35?
Actually, 114 35 has language which indicates, I don't have the statute with me tonight, but it has language which indicates under what circumstances approval by DEP is required. It's clear that under 114 Section 34, the jurisdiction of the Board of Health is there to review and approve the application. And also under a case that goes back to 1926, the town meeting has to approve the cemetery, even after the Zoning Board and the Board of Health have conducted their review and approval. So the referral to DEP, I think, is once the Board of Health receives all the information it has secured, they would determine whether or not DEP review is necessary. And the hearings before the Board of Health, the last two hearings have been continued at the request of the applicant. The hearings have generally been continued at this point at the request of the applicant until the Zoning Board proceeding. So we still have a good deal to go in terms of the Board of Health is concerned. But we do respect the DEP jurisdiction, the Board of Health jurisdiction, town meeting approval under Chapter 114. Section 34, and then the Zoning Board approval under the special permit.
Yes. Just one quick follow-up. So if I'm hearing you correctly, regardless what this bylaw does or the applicability does, it's still going to come at some point to the town for determination whether it'll be a new cemetery or not.
That's correct, yes. This bylaw is only going to address the zoning process. That zoning process is under the Town of Dudley Zoning Bylaw. Chapter 114, Section 34 of the Mass General Laws governs the Board of Health and Town Meeting approval. So yes, this matter will eventually be before town meeting if it's approved by the other boards.
So zoning could say yes, Board of Health could say yes, and the town could say yes or no?
It would appear to be the case, although I would have to say in all good conscience, in advising you, if your zoning board has reviewed and approved it with whatever conditions are appropriate, and if the Board of Health, with or without DEP, has reviewed and approved it and it comes before town meeting, then I think there would have to be a question as to what objective reasons would be given for disapproval by town meeting.
I guess we'll cross that bridge when we get to it. Thank you.
Thank you. Any other discussion? Okay, seeing none, we'll call the vote. All those in favor, please state aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, nay. The ayes have it by majority decision. I recognize Mr. Joseph.
Mr. Moderator, I move we adjourn.
Have a motion to adjourn. Hear no objection. So moved.